One of the other things I find also with Han Yu is that I think he would skate the same, no matter whether there was one person or 8,000 people in the audience. It's he's skating for himself, and we're privileged to be able to be allowed to watch it. Whereas other people perform purely to and with an audience. But we're going to see. This is going to be a very, very interesting group.
Eyes down then, everyone. Buckle up. There's going to be fireworks from the off for this final six. There is Kageyama, Nathan Chen, Keegan Messing, and some final words of preparation for Shoma Uno. The Olympic silver medalist, two-time world silver medalist, four-time Japanese national champion. And he is going to need some magic here to pull himself back onto a world championship podium. It's not out of the question, though.
Quadruple Salco. Slight touchdown on the landing, that will be up for review. Much better on the quadruple flip. Stepped out of the quad toe loop, fully rotated, so the credit will be given, but minus GOE. Saved on the triple axle. That's the way. Quadruple toe loop, double toe. And triple salto, double toe loop. Triple axle, Euler, triple flip.
Still see.
There's no denying his quality is absolutely beautiful skating.
Is that okay? He's had such a rough couple of seasons, regardless of coronavirus and what's gone on this past season from a skating point of view, but that was lovely to see the old Shoma back.
Yeah, he's got his ease back. I think, you know, it was looking like an effort and now it doesn't.
Yeah, he was fighting to make things happen and that's, yeah. Stepped out that one triple, that one quadruple toe loop, and you think, okay, how will that affect you? And then come back with the second, and it was just glorious. Again, it's the honesty in the performances that I really like. There's the quad salco. So yes, there's a touchdown on the landing, maybe on the quarter. Not on the flip though, that was great. And that was the quad toe, double toe, which was the best of the quads. Doesn't get a lot of lift on the entrance into the triple axel, but gets the elements to happen. Down. We have a new leader, but has he done enough to outwit those who have still to skate?
The score is released. So he needs 169.56. to take the lead. Easily done, 184.82. We said there'd be a step up in quality going into this final group, and there you have it, 277.44 lead. .15 over Jason Brown. So a lot of pressure on this chap's shoulders. Keegan Messing of Canada, chosen for the World Championships via a virtual skate-off against his good friend Nam Nagayan. And of course they want two places so the pair of them can go to the Olympics, but it all comes down to what Keegan can produce here.
Quadruple toe loop, double toe loop to start. That was a cracker. Can he knock out the second one? Yes, he can, even better than the first. So Oriola triple salco.
He's looking really comfortable, isn't he?
Absolutely on it right now.
Mm-hmm.
triple loop. Very low on the landing of the triple Lutz, but waited and got that triple toe loop out. A little loose on the landing of the triple axel. Show move. double flip. Wanted that to be the triple. Terrific speed on the spin.
Inspired, skating for fun, Keegan Messing of Canada. He just looked like he was having the time of his life out there. He's been skating on his own mini outdoor rink that he's created, lives in Alaska, where it's been cold enough for him to create his own little ice rink to get out and skate on. Soon to be a father as well, newly married. Life looks good for Keegan Messing, and you know, he's been through so much. He lost his younger brother, didn't he, in a motorbike accident last year. So the heartbreak, the pain to come through that, and all of a sudden the smile's back, the energy's back.
You use it then in your performance, and you know why you're doing things. But he was on fire out there today. Absolutely on it. It was almost like he was doing an exhibition.
He was just bouncing, wasn't he? He didn't look like he was thinking about it. His body seemed to be doing it all automatically.
Well, the first quad was good. The second one was absolutely a cracker. Perfect. Gave away a few points at the end. Look at the height. No question of the rotation. Whoa, wait. And there's the toe loop. Yeah, he did very well to wait. But he knew he was going to do a second one, he needed to be in combination. That's superb, absolutely superb. No review needed for either of those elements. See the tape on the boots. Extra support.
Bit of sellotape. Tape.
Yeah, it's a lot of skaters do it once they're in. Component-wise, it's probably not of the level of a Jason Brown or even of a Shoma, but the technical score is going to be great.
It's a very different proposition as well, though, isn't it?
Yes. But that comes into the interpretation and the composition, you know, performance.
This was very cool. We haven't seen anyone else doing this.
We saw one earlier. There's a couple of girls that are doing it. It's a great ice show move. Yeah, the realization.
I just want to say thank you, Nam. You were there the whole ride through this program.
You see him giving Nam, the guy, in a shout out. His friend, his teammate, the one he was skating for to try and win those two places at the Olympic. I mean, Keegan has said he doesn't even know whether he's going to go for Beijing or not, but he wants Nam to be there. Shout out to Nam watching at home. 176.75 then for Keegan Messing.
Yeah,
and he has done it. He has won that second spot for Canada at the Olympics. So job done. We got the spot, he says. Top work, Keegan Messing. You got the spot, and we enjoyed watching you do it. So Mikhail Koliada, 2018 world bronze medalist, hasn't ever fully reached the potential that many had hoped for him. Eighth at the Pyeongchang Olympics, missed all of the last season to have surgery on his sinusitis, but he is back skating in St. Petersburg.
Exquisite quadruple toe loop, triple toe loop. Look at that, 2.85, over 3 points of GOE now. Phenomenal. And a second one. Spread eagle transition out of that. So difficult. Axel double toe. Needed the hand on the triple salchow landing after the triple Lutz. Shane down on the second triple axel. Fight for the triple flip. There's the triple loop.
Beautiful.
It's such a well-crafted, gorgeous piece of skating choreography. How costly will that triple axel be?
It's not going to be enough to pull him up onto the podium, I shouldn't think, if Chen Kageyama and Han Yu all deliver.
Those first two quads were absolutely gorgeous. But the mistake is going to be costly. Everything else, absolutely exquisite. Level four in the spins, the choreography, step sequence. Yeah, beautiful. It's such a lovely, lovely program. And such a contrast from his short program too, which is nice. So you're seeing a different balance, a different side of somebody. Oof. The soundtrack from The White Crow, which was the movie about Nureyev. Beautiful light in the rotation, perfect execution, and soft into the landings. Hard to believe that's four rotations when it's done that easily and softly. There's the triple axel double toe loop. Again, you would probably have liked that to have been a triple axel triple toe loop. So we've got Lutz. There's the Euler. Triple Sarko didn't quite have the flow through between the two jumps, so the hand came down. So again, little details that would have lost him points. Exquisite footwork in the step sequence. Again, like Jason Brown, he is fully engaged in every move that he's making.
So Mikhail Kolyada sitting in fourth place at the moment. There is Shoma Uno in the champion's chair for now. ...178.52, it's not going to be enough to displace Shoma Uno from that top spot. Mikhail Kolyada slips a spot, but it's going to be enough to have two Russians in the top 10. Now it's time for America's King of the Quads. Nathan Chen has led the world for the past 3 years. He's undefeated since his disappointing fifth place at the Pyeongchang Winter Olympics. He is going for three back-to-back world championships. Will it be the hat trick for Nathan Chen?
Quadruple looks absolutely done with ease. Goodness me, look at that score. Quadruple flip, triple toe loop. And there's the quadruple Salco. Such fast rotation.
Three down, two to go. Quadruple toe loop, Euler triple flip. And quad toe, triple toe. Triple axel. Look at that technical score. And drink it in. You have never seen anything like that at a World Championships before. That is a slice of skating history right there.
And I am standing up as I'm applauding. Unbelievable. Unbelievable.
Oh. And drink it in, because is this the last time we see Nathan Chen at a World Championships? He said he's obviously aiming for Olympic gold at Beijing 2022. After that, he's going to take a break from skating. He's studying at Yale. I mean, he's a brain as well as a talent. And he wants to focus on finishing his study, so he's going to step away from the sport. But oh my goodness, what a performance. Five quads in a free skate at a World Championships. All of them beautiful.
Yep. Plus grade of execution scores from the judges on every single element, I think. Just phenomenal. There's height, there's flight, there's lift. It's perfectly controlled. Oh, my goodness me.
What do you do now if you're Yuzuru Hanyu?
You do what you do every day. You just, he won't know, possibly, what's gone on. I wouldn't want to know.
And he can't hear the cheer either. He can't, if the arena was full, that would have taken the roof off.
This is a breathtaking performance. I'm a huge Philip Glass fan as well, so, you know, the music got me from the first note. Everything was perfection. Yes, Rafa.
Number one.
Look at that. Boom.
Can't wait to see him at the Olympics next winter. Oh. I mean, it would be such a travesty if this man finishes his career without an Olympic gold medal around his neck. Well, we already know that the technical score is going to be monumental. 222.03 for the free skate alone. 320.88.
You know me, I'm not often lost for words. But all I can say is bravo.
I mean, that's over 40 points ahead of the rest of the field, and a steadying hand on the shoulder, because we all need to take a deep breath after that one. Phenomenal skating from Nathan Chen. Under such incredible pressure. Yuma Kageyama then, the junior world silver medalist, the youth Olympic champion, 17 years old. He was third at the Japanese Nationals. And this is his first senior season. Finds himself in the silver medal position after the short program. Can he match Nathan Chen?
Quadruple Salco to open. And there's the quad toe, triple toe to match Nathan Chen in quality on that element. Done in terms of quads. If he pulls this off now, second quad toe loop, and he does. Beautiful. Now hold it together. Triple axel, Euler triple salchow out. Triple lutz, triple loop combination. Just stepped out of the loop. Very difficult triple triple combo though. Over rotation on the triple axel as well. Mm-hmm.
What a talent. Just a couple of scrappy step outs and just the three quads in the pro. I mean, yeah, sorry, Robin, I know that's a ridiculous thing to say, but we've just seen five.
Yes. No, this is where skating's going. What I love is that this young man is making his senior debut internationally here at this championship. The short program is exquisite. There's no questioning the talent. It's just glorious. And he would have heard the score from Nathan. He would have known what had happened. But, oh, yeah. It's just great. I love... I'm in awe of this last group of skaters. The level that these boys and men are skating at is just amazing.
I can't believe what I'm seeing.
And the ease, I think, you know, the ease with which they're rotating, that he's doing this. This quad toe comp, I mean, look at the size of that jump.
He has a bright future ahead of him for sure.
Yeah. And he matched GOE on that quad toe, triple toe with Nathan. Just huge. The jumps are huge. There's so much to be done and so much cleaning and fixing and component scores to be got, but yeah, the talent. Just glorious to watch. I mean, not going to be on a podium this time round, but he will be. There are podiums in his future, many of them, I think.
Definitely. .82 is the free skate score, and that will see him on the world podium.
I take back my words. Well done, young man.
It's going to be a silver at best, a bronze at worst.
In your first senior debut international championship.
What a way to make your mark. So okay. Just as we hoped, it has come down to a shootout between Nathan Chen and Yuzuru Hanyu, the two-time world champion, the reigning and two-time Olympic champion. For many, the very best there has ever been to take to the ice. He is the only man who can stop Nathan Chen from claiming a third consecutive world title.
Quadruple loop, and a hand down. Fallout of that quadruple salco means that gold medal, I think, is gone. That's better. Quadruple toe loop, triple toe loop. Quadruple toe loop, Euler, triple Salco. Again, falling out the landing of the triple axel. Not in combination. So giving away valuable points.
Japan's phenomenal Fairy King just missing that sprinkling of stardust he normally brings to any competition. Just not quite on it today, Yuzuru Hanyu. The world title will go to Nathan Chen.
Yes, he fought valiantly, and towards the end, the quads came back to the quality that we're used to seeing from him, but not without the mistakes, those triple axels, both triple axels, and a tentative start. Very costly.
But, I mean, we saw him skate that phenomenal short program, and we thought, you know, he hasn't been affected by the pandemic. But he clearly has. You know, he's been away from his coach, Brian Orser, in Canada. He's had to train alone in Japan, and he's been shielding because he suffers remarkably from asthma. So just alone on the ice. He says he's learned a lot about himself. He's learned a lot about why he's still skating, what drives him. But maybe that separation from his coaches has been costly.
They've been doing the Zoom meetings, but I sent you the link. You saw the performance he gave at Christmas Day, even on national championships. And it was as incredible then as Nathan's was today, a quad less. So we know he's done it this season. And he's one of those that can take a season off of competition and then come back and make it happen. But today was definitely... not a Hanyu day, but a Nathan day. And Yuzu will have another time. He will have this because he doesn't get affected by the bad performances. He doesn't like them, but he doesn't get affected by them, and he can put them aside.
Do you think we'll see him win another world title?
I don't know. I would love to think we all see him come back, and you know, you want everybody to finish their careers at their best. He's two-time Olympic champion, and he does deserve it. But nobody was going to come close to what Nathan Chen just did.
Superhuman.
And the question is there enough in the bank already from that short program for him to be second?
Well, we'll have to wait and see. He needs 213.91 to take the lead from Nathan Chen. We know that's not going to happen. Wow, 182.20. And no, I don't think that's going to be enough for silver, but it is going to be bronze for Yuzuru Hanyu, the double Olympic champion. A seventh world medal for the incredible Yuzuru Hanyu, but there is your world champion. Three in a row now,
for Nathan Chen. Those five exquisite quads pulling him up from the bronze medal position and up to the top of the standings. So let's have confirmation then. The three Japanese taking fourth, third and second. Shoma Uno, Yuzuru Hanyu the bronze, Yuma Kageyama, the 17-year-old, takes the silver. But three is the magic number for Nathan Chen of the USA, America's king of the quads. And just before we go, Robin, just a reflection on that. I mean, my heart is still racing from that Nathan Chen performance.
Yes, the only thing, I just wish I had been in the venue to witness it live.
Don't.
But he is going to be around, and I cannot wait for Beijing for the Olympics. I just think, but that was beyond special, and it still has me speechless.
Yeah, well, I mean, hopefully we'll hear from the man himself in just a few moments' time. He'll be giving his quick interview, give us some... And he's also honest in his interviews as well, isn't he? And like you say, he promised the five quads. The five quads he delivered, and today was his moment. But there have been so many moments after over the past 3 years since Pyeongchang. He is still unbeaten.
And let's